Hello everyone, welcome to our first Q&A on Wednesday, and we got a lot of questions. Why did you buy this boat? Can you tell me everything about your electrical system? What is the story behind the curtains? What games do you play? And when do you use your mizzenmast? We are going to answer all these questions in a boat tour. In our search for a boat, we were looking for an affordable, ocean-proof yacht. And then our uncle called us and he offered us their boat. And it was the Messenger. So we ended up really blessed because it's way bigger than we thought and it is really ocean-worthy. Here it is, the Messenger. A Trentella 3A, designed by Van der Stad. It's really heavy, it's 7.5 ton. It's 10.8 meters long, 3.2 meters wide. And the long keel has a draft of only 1.4 meters, which is really nice. And it allows us to tuck into really shallow anchorages. Let's get into a quick small tour through the Messenger. Oh, it looks very tidy today. That's coincidence, right?
Yeah, of course. No, it's always like this.
Yeah.
Now let's start in the front where it's not so tidy. This is normally our guest bedroom. But because we are now off the grid for 4 months, we use it as storage. And here we have our second fridge. But we only use it when it's very sunny because it consumes a lot of energy. And this room has one hatch and we put something up there to channel the wind in here. So we made it from a bed sheet and it works very well. And this is the toilet area, but I will let you in.
Small toilet, and on the other side, a sink. It's a good area.
So this is the living area, and there's quite some space to sit around the table with some people, so that's good. And we have a lot of storage places. Here, for example, that's our game cupboard. And we have a lot of games because
someone asked for our games, right?
Yeah, and we love to play games, so we have a lot.
We often play Colonist of Catan.
And someone asked about the curtains as well. My mom made them. And before we left, my mom was making a carpet of these squares. And then Herman said, hey, maybe you can make also curtains for us and put them like three squares next to each other. And we did all different colors and we quite like it.
Yes.
It's a happy vibe.
That's the story of the curtains. Thanks for the question.
Yes. And then we have the kitchen area. And we don't have a gimbaled kitchen. Normally liverboards, they have it. But actually it works without. We have these things to keep the pots in place. And when we are sailing and we need to cook, we just take the fast cooker and it works.
So it works perfect.
We don't have an oven as well, but this is a Wonder Pan.
A miracle pan.
It's called Wonder Pan. And you can bake bread and make lasagna and everything in it. So it's good.
All right, let's go outside.
So this is the cockpit area. Here, everything for navigation is in one place. And it's just the cockpit. And we really like it that it's a center cockpit because when we're out on the sea and it's rough, it's really protected. So it's good. And then we have the bedroom in the back. So this is our bedroom with a nice view on the sea. And the only thing that is a little bit difficult is that these windows can't open. So the only window is the door, so we don't have air flowing through. So we have to use this.
All right, thanks for the quick tour. To move forward, we have four sails. We have a Genoa, a mainsail, and a mizzen. The last one we only use when we are sailing beam reach and close hauled. With a broad reach and running, it doesn't really add speed. So in storms, we have a jib stay. We made that ourselves by using an old main mid, and we just attached it to the front. And now we can just click on our storm jib, and it maybe takes 10 minutes or so. That's good. Then the engine, another way to move forward. We have a Perkins 49 horsepower diesel engine. And we only use it in case of emergency and when we maneuver into a bay or a marina. We had quite some issues with it over the past 2 years, but by now about everything has been refitted and it runs really smooth, so we can rely on it. We stay most of the time on our budget-friendly anchor, so we need to be quite self-sustainable. We need power for 2 fridges, the autopilot, quite a big consumer, and navigational equipment, 2 laptops, phones, cameras, light, fans, and sometimes electrical tools or a blender in the kitchen. Our main source of electricity are 2 solar panels. You see them behind me. They can move with the sun, so that's really nice. In total, the panels give 320 watts, and in general, about 10 a.m. in the morning, our battery pack from 360 amperes is completely full and stays 100% the whole day. And in case of emergency, when we sail long distances, we can use our engine, which runs 2 alternators as a backup. And one important thing is we try to save energy by only using 12 volts in general, and only when really necessary we use the inverter. Another great feature of this boat, it feels like I'm selling this boat, but it's just a good boat, is the tanks. Like, we have 400 liters of diesel in the tank, and we have 400 liters of water in the tank, so it's a big amount for the size. And for this trip we are 4 months off the grid, so we took the double amount, 400 liters in bottles extra. And we really try to save the fresh water by only using it for drinking and cooking, and we do the dishes with salt, we shower with salt, everything. So it's really basic lifestyle. For this video we used quite some footage from the past 2 years, and if you got interested to watch the stories behind that footage, we add some links in the description, so you can click on it and go to the whole episode. For now, this was the first Question Wednesday, and we got questions from Charles, Gio, Genie, Atma, Janet, Ad, Jan, Henry, Cora. So many people responded, and the camera is almost falling. So thanks for that. Next Wednesday we have another one. So feel free to ask any question you desire, and we will try to answer them. Thanks for watching for now, and peace out.